Hi, it's Brittany. This is outside of the thing, I know, but it's a voiceover. But listen, this video made me scream and cry. It was very hard to do. You're seeing an hour and some odd minutes. It took me 2.5 hours to make, and there were so many cuts and everything. And then, like, to go in and realize when I'm finally getting to the end of fixing it that my damn audio, the voice, the like, hello, hi, how are you at the beginning, did not record well because the Skyrim music is obnoxious but amazing. So I'm just saying hi over the top of it so that you know that I said hi, because for some reason that's important to me. And I'm going to go now. So thank you and enjoy. Goodbye.
I'm sorry I drink so loud. I'm gonna get some more water while it goes. It's much nicer. Much more shiny. I like it. They got the water, we're ready to wash. Pardon me as I scoot my chair in. Oh, that looks so pretty now. Very nice. Much nicer. It is still windy as hell, though. All right, what quests do we have? What do? Speak to Astrid. Okay, so I don't really know if I want to join the Dark Lord. The Golden Claw? Oh, bring the claw to Lucan. Who's Lucan? I mean, okay. Guess we're going to Riverwood.
those Whiterun gods can take down the dragon, so can we.
Sure, yeah. I believe you. Or see. I got a mod that makes my horse 30% faster because it felt weird that he was, like, basically going the same, like, speed that I could just, like, run.
One of us has to do something.
I said no. No adventures, no theatrics, no thief chasing.
Well, what are you going to do then, huh? Let's hear it.
We are done talking about this. Oh, a customer.
Hi.
Sorry you had to hear that.
That's fine. Forget it.
Well, I don't know what you overheard, but the Riverwood Trader is still open. Feel free to shop. We did have a bit of a break in. We still have plenty to sell. Robbers were only after one thing. An ornament. Solid gold in the shape of a dragon's claw. You found it!
Yep.
There it is! Strange. It seems smaller than I remember. Funny thing, huh? I'm gonna put this back where it belongs. I'll never forget this. You've done a great thing for me and my sister.
No problem.
Thank you so much for taking care of those thieves. The Riverwood Trader is back to the way it used to be.
Yay.
I think I have a few old spell books laying about. If you want more, you'll have to go to the College of Winterhold.
Sure, have some memorabilia from a murderer. I hope I don't need these. Zombie. Come back when I have more money.
All right, then.
At present, I'm a bit broke.
Costume? You're not serious.
Sure I am. We got some firs and tree branches, paint them white, and then tie them to stone. Instant frostbite fire.
Frodnar.
don't like my necromancer rope because it's got that.
No one's gonna believe that your dog is a frostbite spider. And if they do, they'll kill him. That's not much.
Staying out of trouble, kinsman.
Oh yeah.
Yes. Maybe.
We play tag. You're it.
Hey, no fair! Get her stump.
Love that dog. He's so cute. Where'd my horse go? Oh, there he is.
A fine day to you, friend. May you die with a sword in your hands.
Right. Okay. A lot would have to happen for me to die with a sword on my hand. I'm just saying. All right. Hi, Hrothgar. That's where we gotta go. To learn to be dragonborn.
So, a dragonborn appears at this moment in the turning of the age.
You call me a dragonborn. What does that even mean?
First, let us see if you truly are dragonborn. Let us taste of your voice.
Taste? Okay.
Strike us with the power of your voice.
That seems like a bad idea. Like, dude, I don't want to hurt you.
Shout for us, Dragonborn.
Shout. Okay.
Of your voice.
Foos!
Dragon. I am Master Angir. I speak for the Greybeards. Now, tell me, Dragonborn, why have you come here?
I'm answering.
We are honored to welcome a Dragonborn to High Hrothgar. We will do our best to teach you how to use your gift in fulfillment of your destiny.
Okay, so I have a destiny. What is it?
That is for you to discover. We can show you the way, but not your destination.
Okay. How will you know what way I'm supposed to go if you don't know my destination, though? Autism questions. I want to find out what it means.
We are here to guide you in that pursuit. Just as the Greybeards have sought to guide those of the dragon blood that came before you. You are not the first. There have been many of the dragon blood since Akatosh first bestowed that gift upon mortal kind. Whether you are the only dragonborn of this age, that is not ours to know. You are the only one that has been revealed thus far. That is all I can say. You have shown that you are dragonborn. You have the inborn gift. But do you have the discipline and temperament to follow the path laid out for you?
I don't know. It depends on the path.
That it remains to be seen. Without training, you have already taken the first steps towards projecting your voice into a thum, a shout. Now let us see if you are willing and able to learn. When you shout, you speak in the language of dragons. Your dragon blood gives you an inborn ability to learn words of power. All shouts are made up of three words of power. As you master each word, your shout will become progressively stronger. Master Einarth will now teach you Ro, the second word in Unrelenting Force. Ro means balance in the dragon tongue. Combine it with Fus, force, to focus your thum more sharply. Ro. Well, that is how the rest of us learn shouts. As Dragonborn, you can absorb a slain dragon's life knowledge directly. As part of your...
Okay, before we continue, I need to put the subtitles back on because I can hardly hear with music the way it is. Let's just drop that down a little bit. And then... I genuinely need subtitles and general subtitles. It's not that I can't hear, it's that sounds all kind of rumble together in my brain. So, let's see. Cool. Let's try this now.
Initiation, Master Einarth will allow you to tap into his understanding of Ro. Now, let us see how quickly you can master your new thum. Use your unrelenting force shout to strike the targets as they appear.
Okay.
Oh,
Okay.
Well done. Again. Use both words if you can. Use both Fus and Ro. Together they will make the shout more powerful. You learn quickly. Once more. Impressive. Your thumb is precise. You show great promise, Dragonborn.
Thank you.
We will perform your next trial in the courtyard. Follow Master Bori.
Master Bori. Okay. We're just going to slow walk everywhere. All right, I guess we are. So much as a courtyard is a frost place, like Jesus. It's very cold here. Do we have to do this?
We will now see how you learn a completely new shout. Master Bori will teach you Wuld, which means whirlwind.
All right. Wuld.
You must hear the word within yourself before you can project it into a thum. Approach Master Bori and he will gift you his knowledge of wood. Now we will see how quickly you can master a new shout. Master Wolfgar will demonstrate whirlwind sprint. Then it will be your turn. Master Bori. X. Wolf.
Akas.
Now it's your turn. Stand next to me. Master Bori will open the gate. Use your whirlwind sprint to pass through before it closes.
Okay.
X.
Who's bro?
Oops. I don't think I demonstrated that.
Your quick mastery of a new thum is astonishing. I'd heard the stories of the abilities of Dragonborn, but to see it for myself? You were given this gift by the gods for a reason. It is up to you to determine how best to use it.
Right.
You are now ready for your last trial. Retrieve the horn of Jürgen Windcaller, our founder, from his tomb in the ancient fane of Ostengrav. Remain true to the way of the voice, and you will return. No doubt, the appearance of a dragonborn at this time is not an accident. Your destiny is surely bound up with the return of the dragons. You should focus on honing your voice, and soon your path will be made clear.
Cool.
There is indeed much that we know that you do not. That does not mean that you are ready to understand it.
All right, fair.
Do not let your easy mastery of the voice tempt you into the arrogance of power. That has been the downfall of many dragonborn before you.
All right.
Five. Our leader, Partanax, lives alone on the peak of the throat of the world. When your voice can open the path, you will know you are ready to speak to him.
Okay.
He was a great war leader of the ancient Nords, a master of the voice, or tongue. After the disaster at Red Mountain, where the Nord army was annihilated, he spent many years pondering the meaning of that terrible defeat. He finally came to realize that the gods had punished the Nords for their arrogant and blasphemous misuse of the voice. He was the first to understand that the voice should be used solely for the glory and worship of the gods, not the glory of men. Jürgen Windcaller's mastery of the voice eventually overcame all opposition. And the way of the voice was born. The voice was a gift of the goddess Kinnereth at the dawn of time. She gave mortals the ability to speak as dragons do. Although this gift has often been misused, the only true use of the voice is for the worship and glory of the gods. True mastery of the voice can only be achieved when your inner spirit is in harmony with your outward actions. In the contemplation of the sky, Kinnereth's domain, and the practice of the voice, we strive to achieve this balance.
This guy is very, like, there's a lot that could very easily be pulled apart of his argument. I'm not going to, because that would be dickish of me, but it really feels like a lot of his argument could be very easily pulled apart.
The Dragonborn is an exception to all the rules. The dragon blood itself is a gift of the gods. If we accept one gift, how can we deny the other? As Dragonborn, you have received the ability to shout directly from Akatosh. We therefore seek to guide you on the proper use of your gift, which transcends the restrictions which bind other mortals.
I'm not a fan of the, oh, you're better than other mortals for this, magic.
We study the way of the voice, according to the teachings of our founder, Jürgen Windcaller. Very few are permitted to study with us here at High Hrothgar. But in your case, Dragonborn, it is a privilege to guide you towards mastery of your voice. Their voices are too powerful for anyone not trained in the way to withstand. Even a whisper could kill you.
Damn. Okay.
Sky, guard you.
So now I have to go here, I guess. I gotta go retrieve old dude's horn now. World map fell. Awesome. So that is Ustengarv is there. So I'm going to go to Whiterun. Fast travel to Whiterun. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Get me off this mountain, please. Alright. We need to go there. Remove it. We need to go there. Abandoned shaft. Oh shit, that's where I was earlier. Oh hell yeah, I can just fast travel over there and we can do the thing. Awesome. Well, this looks much less ominous and creepy at night. Please don't tell me that I'm going to go over here and it's going to be that exact same thing from earlier. Like, because last episode I went over here and there was like a necromancer situation or something. I'm going to laugh my ass off. It's the same one. Could have just done this crap earlier. It is. Son of a bitch. Okay, well. Weapon. Gonna need an axe here.
You hear that? The others must have found something.
Magic. Resto. For sure, for sure.
We'd better go see. These can tend to themselves for a few minutes.
This is new. Woodcutter's axe, huh? Yeah, this was full of, like, necromancers or something earlier. Thank you. need to just go full ass magic. She is ugly. Okay, so only a necromancer could love. Aw, look at you. I get very intense when I'm in places like this. Sorry about that. Love. the right way? No idea where I'm going. Yes, stamina, magic. That's good. I like these. Like somebody tried to come through here. Sometimes. Death to you, sir. That looks like a door, doesn't it? Frost for you. Jeez Louise, Gimpus, Gomeo. Air poison. Drains the target's magic. Target. Cheese. What? I'm carrying too much cheese. Lame. Is it the weapons? Love that. T charge. love staff flames. I do want to see if I can't get multiple things. Maybe that's cheeky, but... I am so turned around in here. It's not even funny. Ooh! Scared me! Absolutely terrified me there. Jumped out of my seat. I knew it was coming too. I was looking at that. I was just like, you know what? This gonna spook me. And it did. Skull, that's what those are. Ruined books, weak fear potion. Anything else of value? No? God, this place is spooky. Oh, those are. Skeletons. Skeletons. Oh, it freaks me out. How do I get up there? Nah, that's what I have to say to that. There has to be a way for me to get over. Like, you wouldn't show me something and then not let me get it. Hey. An orcish sword. Big fancy. is scary. I just need to get old dude's horn. Right? That was in this one, right? Always check under a waterfall. Always. Oh, but it's not here. Okay. Oh. This way? Nope, that's not it. So slow. Bones. Thank you. Why is it not working? About to believe that I shouldn't become a dragonborn. Oh my god. Okay. This is getting very frustrating. Is there like a skip through thing or something so that I can just like you're seeing this, right? See me do that shit. Come on. It's a little ridiculous. Oh god, it's all fire. Okay, cool. Well, dude likes his fire, I guess. Out of charges. Okay, destruction. Sparks. Really? Oh my god. Okay. If I get stuck, I'll do it. But this is not something that I like doing. This is not a thing that I enjoy. I like trying to play these games as best as I can. Whew. But that was not fun. that. And the damn horn isn't even here. Oh. Somebody is gonna get blasted into oblivion. Something in. All right. I'll meet you at the inn. This has been one hell of a fucking thing. Woof. Damn near had a panic attack. Couldn't figure out how to get past the damn thing. Got lost. I swear. There are times when I just don't think I'm meant to game. Knew that was a door. Trusty horse. Bless you for staying where you needed to be. All right. Let's go to leave it. Oh, well. Whatever. Riverwood. Yes. Go to the inn, rent a room. Oh, man. This has been a situation and a half. Here. So you're not in the
way. Wait, so a costume? You're not serious.
Sure I am.
That's the traitor.
Feindahl thinks he can woo Camilla Valerius away from me. She's already mine, I keep telling him.
Dude. Maybe she doesn't belong to anybody. You ever thought of that?
Need a room? Talk to Delphine. All right, then.
I'm the innkeeper. It's my business to keep track of strangers. Attic room, eh? Well, we don't have an attic room, but you can have the one on the left. Make yourself at home.
Your left or my left? Left. Dyslexia. Oh. This one? I think it's this one.
So you're the Dragonborn I've been hearing so much about. I think you're looking for this. We need to talk. Follow me.
Okay.
We got rooms, drink too. I cook. Ain't much else to tell.
Close the door. Now we can talk. The Greybeards seem to think you're the Dragonborn. I hope they're right. Surprised? I guess I'm getting pretty good at my harmless innkeeper act.
Can I marry you?
You can't be too careful. Thalmor spies are everywhere. I didn't go to all this trouble on a whim. I needed to make sure it wasn't a Thalmor trap. I am not your enemy. I already gave you the horn. I'm actually trying to help you. I just need you to hear me out.
Absolutely, yeah. Go on, I'm listening.
Like I said in my note, I've heard that you might be Dragonborn.
Yeah.
I'm part of a group that's been looking for you. Well, someone like you, for a very long time.
Okay.
If you really are Dragonborn, that is. Before I tell you any more, I need to make sure I can trust you.
Okay. Oh, why did you take the horn?
I knew the Greybeards would send you there if they thought you were Dragonborn. They're nothing if not predictable.
Fair.
When you showed up here, I knew you were the one the Greybeards sent, and not some Thalmor plant. We remember what most don't, that the Dragonborn is the ultimate dragon slayer. You're the only one that can kill a dragon permanently by devouring its soul.
Okay.
Can you do it? Can you devour a dragon's soul?
Yep. That's how I first learned I was
Good.
Dragonborn.
And you'll have a chance to prove it to me soon enough. Yes. We're very old enemies. And if my suspicions are correct, they might have something to do with the dragons returning. But that isn't important right now. What is important is that you might be Dragonborn.
I totally am.
Dragons aren't just coming back. They're coming back to life. They weren't gone somewhere for all these years. They were dead, killed off centuries ago by my predecessors. Now something's happening to bring them back to life, and I need you to help me stop it.
Okay.
I know they are. I visited their ancient burial mounds and found them empty. And I figured out where the next one will come back to life. We're going to go there, and you're going to kill that dragon. If we succeed, I'll tell you anything you want to know.
Okay. Sounds legit.
Kynesgrove, there's an ancient dragon burial near there. If we can get there before it happens, maybe we'll learn how to stop it.
All right. Okay, so I think I'm going to leave this episode here, and, boy, we had some fucking problems today. Jeez Louise, we had some fucking problems today. Alright, so, we're gonna leave this episode here. We're going to, save, and then we're going to go and kill the dragon in the next episode. Alright, so, hopefully you had a great time, watching me fumble around in the dark. Alright, I love you, goodbye! Oh, like, subscribe, do that thing if you want to. But you don't have to, but if you want to, you can. Alright, bye.
I can't wait around for you to make up your mind. I'll meet you at Kynesgrove. Don't waste time getting there.
All right, Lady Jesus. Save.